What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Joshua Partegi here. In today's video, I'd like to talk about the differences between Agile Coach and Scrum Master. Ooh, this is going to be very controversial. But if you'd like to hear my opinion on this topic, don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. Last year, I had an experience working with an external Agile coach, and she didn't allow me to work at the enterprise level to coach the management and the whole organization because she said, as a Scrum Master, I should only work at the team level. I was really surprised, and at the same time, I was disappointed an Agile coach would say that. There are a lot of misconceptions in the market regarding the Scrum Master role when compared to Agile coach role. We can see some of these opinions on YouTube also. So in today's video, I'd like to bust some of these myths regarding the Scrum Master role when compared to Agile Coach role. Now, it's really hard to compare the Agile Coach role to the Scrum Master role because unlike Scrum that has one definition and that is called the Scrum Guide, there isn't any one definition regarding the Agile Coach role. When we search on the internet, people on the internet sphere will form their own opinion regarding the Agile Coach role, and oftentimes these opinions are really biased. It really depends on who is talking. So to prevent further confusion, in today's video, I won't form my own opinion regarding the Agile Coach role. Now, when comparing Agile Coach to Scrum Master, after reading the opinions on the internet regarding Agile Coach, I have found it's like cola drinks. There are no differences. The only difference are the labels and the company that made it. The first myth I found in the market is people think that the Scrum Master only knows Scrum, while Agile Coach knows more than just Scrum. There is a common misperception that if you call yourself a Scrum Master, you're limiting yourself to just Scrum and you only use Scrum. The term Scrum Master was inspired by the term Zen Master. Zen is one of the school of Buddhism. Just like Zen, what's matter most in Scrum is the values and principles. Scrum is more about empiricism rather than the mechanics. So mastering Scrum literally is about mastering empiricism. Mastering empiricism is a lifelong learning.
When we read Scrum Guide, it says that Scrum is not a process, technique, or definitive method. Scrum is a framework within which you can employ various processes and techniques. Specific tactics for using the Scrum framework vary and are described elsewhere. So as a framework, you can say that Scrum is just like a container or a bucket where you can put in other complementary Agile practices like Kanban, Extreme Programming, DevOps, Lean UX, etc.
So from here, we can learn that the two co-founders of Scrum, Ken Schwaber and Jeff Sutherland, acknowledge that Scrum by itself is not enough. The Scrum Master should work with the organization using Scrum as an empirical process control to self-discover what are the most appropriate Agile practices for their context. The second myth I found in the market is people think that the Scrum Master is a team level only role and only make changes at the team level, while Agile Coach is an enterprise level role and make changes at the enterprise level. Many Scrum Masters start working at the team level, but awesome Scrum Masters do not stop at the team level only. The idea of Scrum is improvement should start from where people are actually doing the work, and that is at the team level. As time progresses and the organization evolves, the Scrum Master improves his or her effectiveness in making changes within the company and starts spreading his or her services throughout the company.
Optimizing the Scrum team performance only is suboptimal because the Scrum team does not work in isolation and need to work with other departments within the company. The Scrum Master should optimize the delivery of value holistically within the company. In Ken Schwaber's book, The Enterprise Scrum, he talks about using Scrum at the enterprise level. So that is why when we read Scrum Guide, besides serving the product owner and the development team, the Scrum Master should also serve the whole organization.
I have made a video on the Scrum Master accountability within the company. If you're interested to learn more about the Scrum Master accountability, click the link up here to watch the video. The third myth I found in the market is people think that the Scrum Master only have technical skills and does not have the coaching skills to coach at the enterprise level and coach the management, while Agile Coach have the necessary coaching skills to coach at the enterprise level and coach the management. Scrum Masters need to mentor and teach everyone in the company to improve the company's agility. Scrum Masters definitely need to know more than just facilitating that daily Scrum every morning.
When we read Scrum Guide, the word coaching is mentioned several times as one of the services the Scrum Master provide to the whole company. That means the Scrum Master should know about coaching just like an Agile coach. Many Scrum Masters came from technical background, but it doesn't mean the Scrum Master should stop there. Scrum Masters are expected to add coaching skills into his or her tool belt to be able to bring organization change more effectively.
Besides coaching skills, the Scrum Master should also have teaching and facilitation skills. The Scrum Master also uses mentoring and servant leadership stance to bring change within the company. I have made a video on Scrum Master stances and when to use it. If you haven't watched it already, click the link up here to watch the video. Semantically, by dictionary, a master is the highest form of expertise. Even though a lot of companies want to create a career path, but putting a master below a coach or putting a master as an entry-level job is very confusing. So that is all from me today, folks. I hope you have a different perspective about Agile Coach and Scrum Master after watching this video. If you liked today's video, don't forget to smash that like button. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you won't miss any of my video in the future. See you until my next video. Bye.